Today, I bought $40 worth of credits so we can spend it all on the AI generator and generate pictures that don't even exist. Chat, I'm talking about cats on fire trucks, cities in the sky, cardboard box Lamborghinis, and many more. Sit back, relax, make sure you guys grab some snacks, click the little full screen button down there. Today, we are going to be generating the prompts Rick Astley, In the Future, House on a Waterfall, and even Victorian London paintings, my absolute favorite. Guys, make sure you stick around to the end. Let's go! We have 42 credits left. What would happen if we type in Rick Astley in the AI generator? Because there's so many pictures of him. I think I want to do Rick Astley as the first one. We want portrait, we want realistic. Let's do 800 iterations with no outside information other than Rick Astley. What does the AI generate? No freaking way! Kinda messed up a little bit, but that's definitely Rick Astley with no further information other than Rick Astley. This is what it generates. Probably not the best generation possible. We could probably do a little bit better, but get Rickrolled by an AI, huh? There's a lot of stairway ones. We could try Life on Mars. I'm curious what the AI thinks of what In the Future mean, or it's just gonna draw a blob and say, yep, that's what I think the future is. But again, yes, it is a lot of luck. 800 iterations in the future. Let's see what it comes up with. Now here is the result for Through the Fire and the Flames. What did it do? What is happening? Kind of started with that, and then it came all the way to this and just kept going, I guess. I don't know what's going on. The future, chat. What does it think the future looks like? This apparently. Like, I want to see like how it compares like different things. Do Victorian London. Oh, medium pencil sketch. Should we do a pencil sketch for this one? I feel like that would direct the AI a little bit closer because it's basically black and white anyways. Pencil or oil? Oil's a good one. Actually, I didn't know there's so much to art, man. I guess there is quite a bit of different ways to portray something. I don't know. Here's some pictures of Victorian London, and we'll see how well it can do. This is gonna be definitely interesting, chat. So should we do that? We should do oil, I guess. Like, you can get detail with oil painting. I just feel like there's not enough detail. Okay, you know what? Never mind. We're doing oil. We're doing oil, chat. Should we type in the thing oil painting? Full max amount of iterations. Let's freaking do this. Go! And here's what the AI thinks the future is gonna look like with the settings we gave it. That is very interesting. I'm actually like you get these weird shapes. You get these weird rounded shapes and maybe some square shapes in some of the buildings. The way it's generating these images, I'm pretty sure I'm satisfied with this, with how this went. Because you can obviously see a window. This is obviously a building. Window, 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 window. Some fancy thing around the window that's probably costs way too much. Another window. Now let's check out what the Victorian London painting looks like. It's not totally done yet, but I just want to take a little look, see what's going on. This is pretty good. You have the clothing style. It's not far off. The building style. Oh no, it's gonna get so much better. Well, that's fabricating, I guess. I'm pretty sure an AI might be able to do a waterfall pretty well. Although the backgrounds is always the problem. Cause it's like, okay, so you have Rick Astley. The AI doesn't know how to generate the background to Rick Astley. It's just gonna put some random shapes in there and call it good. What can we do? House on top of a waterfall in the sunlit woods. That sounds pretty good. I think it gives enough detail for the background. It gives a waterfall, it gives a house. Gives it something to work with. I wish I could paint like that. No need to. You got it right here. So I want to get as much accuracy as possible because I think there's a lot going on there. So I don't think we need a medium. I'm gonna do another 1,200 iterations. House on top of a waterfall in sunlit woods. Let's check this out. And then we're also gonna go over to the Victorian London painting. I can't complain. That isn't as detailed as I thought it would be. Some of the buildings have that London-y feel, all right? Style, right? The style of clothing, I think, is right. I don't know why there's a building on top of another building. Maybe we should have said cityscape or something like that to add a little bit more detail, but pretty good. I like it. It has the spikes on the top, right? That's pretty good. Let's see the first iteration on house on top of a waterfall. See what it gets us. Yo, wait a minute. Oh shit, that is cool. It's a wonky looking house, but dude, it got three houses in a waterfall and one's in the trees, chat. There's a house in the trees. That is sick. I mean, there's probably better settings for this, but it got the waterfall down. And it got the houses on top of the waterfall. I don't see really where this water flow is coming from, but it's a waterfall. That's awesome. House on top of a waterfall in the sunlit woods. You got the sunset, you got the sun. I don't know why the sun is right there where it is, But there's water, there's rocks, there's houses, there's a woods, there's a sun, there's clouds behind it. That's awesome. This is crazy, chat. Anyways, those of you on YouTube, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you haven't already, make sure you subscribe. Click the next videos if you see something you're interested in. If you got to this point, make sure you check out the rest of my videos. I'll see you guys later. Catch you in the next one. Peace.